We had a major announcement on Monday that definitely deserves a closer look. Google presented an exceedingly difficult problem to one of the world's fastest traditional supercomputers, which simply couldn't handle the task, even if given all the time that the universe existed from the Big Bang until today. It also gave the same task to its new Willow quantum computer, which solved it in under 5 minutes. I'll describe that task and more, but first, what is quantum computing? As the name implies, that's a type of computing that's based on quantum mechanics, which is the fundamental theory that describes the behavior of the smallest particles known to man. Notable figures in the field include Max Planck, who did pioneering work on black body radiation, and who proposed that energy is emitted or absorbed in discrete units called quanta, laying the groundwork for quantum theory. Albert Einstein, who built on the idea of quanta to explain the photoelectric effect, proposing that light behaves like particles as well as like waves, involving what we refer to today as photons. Werner Heisenberg, who was a key architect of modern quantum theory. He formalized quantum mechanics using matrices. Of course, there were many other important pioneers in the field as well, some of which you can see here. Whereas traditional computing uses bits, which can have a state of 0 or 1, quantum computing uses quantum bits or qubits, which can represent 0 or 1, or a blend of both simultaneously, due to the fact that a qubit can exist in multiple states at the same time. The technical term for this is superposition, and so qubits can interact with each other in very complex ways. Also, traditional computers process information sequentially, or if information is processed in parallel, multiple processors are required to do that. But with quantum computing, a single processor can investigate a vast array of possibilities all at once. By 1994, Peter Shor demonstrated that quantum computers could factorize large numbers exponentially faster than traditional computers. And 2 years later, Grover's algorithm enabled quantum computers to search unsorted databases quadratically faster than traditional computers. In short, already by the 1990s, quantum computing was known to be highly efficient and very fast. That said, a key issue is that these types of systems have much higher error rates than traditional computers, which is due to the fact that quantum states are very fragile and can change their state or lose information easily as a result of electromagnetic noise in circuits, or physical vibrations, or fluctuations in temperature. Even very minor disturbances can disrupt them, even cosmic rays, unlike classical bits, which are fairly robust. So, to work as intended, qubits need to be in a place that's cold, dark, and quiet. And I mean cold. Qubit chips are placed inside of some of the coldest places in the universe, about 300 times colder than outer space. With that as context, let's return again to this week's announcement. One of the most important factors is that Willow has now demonstrated an approach to quantum error correction that reduces errors exponentially as the scale increases. With Willow, error rates are cut in half each time the grid is increased in size to the next scaling factor. That's the opposite of what happened in the past. Also, tests show that any required error corrections can all be done in real time. And that's remarkable because, as mentioned, these chips are very vulnerable, very error-prone. But the Willow system compensates for this by running processes millions of times, which they can do in just minutes, which is a very short time compared to the resources you'd need to do the same simulation on a traditional computer. The test I just described that was achieved in 5 minutes was something called random circuit sampling, which is considered to be the hardest benchmark that can be done on a quantum computer today. Think of a quantum computer as a very complex machine with many tiny switches, which are the qubits, which, as we know, can be in multiple states at the same time. With random circuit sampling, we randomly flip those switches in a certain way and then measure the final state of all the switches. And we repeat that process many times, recording the different final states and how often they occur. And this gives a probability distribution of all the possible outcomes. And because we're actually measuring the outcomes of quantum phenomena, classical computers are at a big disadvantage in this. It's like bringing a knife to a gunfight. In comparison to a similar test that was done 5 years ago, where state-of-the-art traditional supercomputers were compared to state-of-the-art quantum computing, as it was in 2019, this week's result has widened the gap at a double exponential rate. In other words, the gap between quantum and traditional methods is widening very, very fast. And that's even more remarkable when you consider that traditional computing is also advancing very fast. Traditional supercomputers are now about a million times better than they were in 2019. And so, to chart a course, Google has projected what they believe would be required for a quantum computer to deliver commercial value. For that to happen, they think they need a computer with 1,000 logical qubits made up from about 1 million physical qubits. And they published a roadmap of how to get there with 6 milestones. And this week's announcement brings them about halfway through that roadmap, basically at around the 3rd milestone. So they're more or less on track with their plan. Specifically, one of the key milestones of Willow was a 5x growth in the length of time that qubits maintain their intended state, increasing from 20 microseconds with Sycamore to 100 microseconds with Willow, which is a key reason why Willow is now able to operate below what's known as the critical quantum error correction threshold. That threshold is the point where a shield becomes strong enough to protect a quantum computer from more errors than it corrects. And that's a tipping point for getting to large-scale, fault-tolerant quantum computers. It's a long sought-after goal in the field ever since the 1990s. As hardware director Julian Kelly explains, a big challenge is that qubits can have very unequal levels of performance. Often, there are a few outliers that have very high error rates. And Willow addresses that situation by tuning those qubits to perform in line with the rest of the device. And then, taking that one step further, that tuning capability is then used to push errors down across all the qubits in the whole device using software. Google's engineering VP Harmut Neven describes himself in jest as having a role of chief optimist at quantum AI. And in that vein, he projects that we're only a few years out from a commercially viable product, 5 years max. In sum, this is certainly a fast-evolving field, and passing the critical quantum error correction threshold was a very important step towards attaining the vision of commercial applications with quantum computing in this decade. So stay tuned. Meanwhile, thanks for watching, and see you next time.